In the last video, I went over the easy steps to turn a Steam Deck into a wireless dual-screen gaming device. I get that not everyone has a Steam Deck though, and I'd hate for folks to miss out on quality dual-screen emulation just because their pockets aren't deep enough to afford one. Fortunately, the general process for connecting any device you own for wireless dual-screen gaming is pretty much the same as with the Steam Deck. Unfortunately, with the vast variety of devices you could use, comes some awkwardness where certain devices feel a little better to use than others. In this video, I'll be focusing on the details that tend to shift the most for different setups, primarily Steam Link display focus issues, optimal display settings you'll want to consider, and the nuances of controller input via Steam Link. After I go through that, I'll also make some general recommendations for types of devices I've found ideal while testing different setups for these videos. Feel free to use the included chapters to skip around as needed. Okay, to start, let's recap the methodology to set up wireless dual screen emulation. You only really need 5 things to get up and running. 1, a computer to stream from that's capable of running both Steam and a dual screen emulator like Simu or Citra. 2, at least 2 displays connected to that computer. 3, a secondary device with a touchscreen capable of running Steam Link. 4, a controller or keyboard to actually play your games. And then finally, 5, a fast, stable internet connection, since, you know, we're streaming everything over Wi-Fi. With those 5 items in hand, connect your second monitor to the device you plan to stream from while running Steam. Use Steam Link on the secondary device to connect with that first computer over Wi-Fi. And then launch whatever dual screen emulator you're interested in, with the top and bottom screens split between your 2 displays. Finally, just use the controller to play your game. It's really that easy. And, you know, admittedly, there are a ton of extra settings I'll get into later to make the stream look as good as it could. But that's the general premise here. Just connect a display, use Steam Link, and get up and running. My initial setup focused on the Steam Deck primarily because it's the closest to an all-in-one solution I've come across that takes the least amount of fiddling to get up and running and look good. Well, as long as you don't mind 800p streams. If you were to run SteamOS on an ROG Ally, Ionia 2, or one of the various other handheld PCs on the market, you'd likely get very similar results. However, once you start wanting to stream gameplay from a Windows or macOS device, or stream gameplay to an Android or iOS device, everything just gets a little bit more finicky. Different operating systems handle Steam Link differently on both sides of the equation, and there's a lot of trial and error involved with recreating the Steam Deck experience using other devices. A huge part of the differences between devices often just boils down to how Steam Link handles multiple displays and on which operating system you've actually chosen to run your emulators. On both Windows and macOS, Steam Link switches the stream's focus to whatever display contains the mouse cursor. It's pretty jarring and limits all macOS and Windows devices to only be good to use as the main display of the stream. If you plan to use Windows or macOS devices, know going in that you'll probably want your secondary device, that is the device that you're streaming to contain your touchscreen during gameplay. For anyone who finds all of this a pain, there is an easy workaround to consider. Just install an Arch Linux distro. After testing Manjaro and SteamOS, it's looking like Arch Linux is the one set of operating systems for which Steam Link doesn't change display focus based on mouse cursor location. Instead, it streams whatever display is arranged to the furthest left every time. That predictability and ease of use will likely make it the best route for any dedicated setups. Once you've settled on an operating system though, the next main hurdles are related to display settings. Primarily, this boils down to making sure that your touchscreen functions properly with the resolution set by your stream. This part is the most tricky to set up and will likely take some trial and error to get right due to some limitations regarding the Steam Link stream. From my experience, Steam Link streams seem to have a size limit for touch input depending on the computer you're streaming from. Newer, more performant computers will typically be able to stream both displays at higher resolution without losing out on touch, whereas older computers may need to be lowered to 720p or below. Going beyond a computer's limits tends to result in offset touch input on the touchscreen, which isn't great for dual screen emulation. As a couple examples, my desktop computer, a Windows 11 machine with an RTX 3060 and i7-11700K, can stream dual 1440p displays without an issue. Meanwhile, my Surface Book, a Windows 10 machine with a GTX 965M and i7-6600U, only has usable streams at 720p. To assess how well your setup functions, I'd recommend starting with both your streaming displays at the same resolution while viewing your desktop. If you touch your secondary device and see a huge offset in the mouse cursor, drop both your displays to a lower resolution. Repeat this process until your touch input functions accurately. Now, this doesn't mean that you're stuck streaming at the highest resolution you land upon. That resolution is more so the upper limit your stream can handle. You can still drop the resolution on your secondary display to something more manageable that requires less streaming bandwidth. While I can stream to my Retroid Pocket Flip at up to 1440p, the display can only handle 720p video anyway. By setting my secondary display to 720p, I still get the same performance while needing to push less data over Wi-Fi and making my stream just a tiny bit more stable. For folks whose only option is something like my Surface Book and its 720p streams, there's also a workaround if you want higher quality video. On your secondary display, you can swap your stream's mouse control from direct control to trackpad input. Doing so will give you fine control over the mouse cursor, even if the stream can't accurately map the location of your touchpoint to your display. The main downside with this approach is slower, more awkward input control, as well as less immersion in general. Still, it might be worthwhile if you'd otherwise have to rely on very low quality streams. There's just one final hurdle to tackle: your controller. Generally speaking, any controller can be used for this kind of setup, as long as it's properly recognized by your operating system. As a hard and fast rule, controllers using X input are preferable for ease of use. I'll drop links to a few controllers I like down in the video description if you don't have something on hand already. The main restriction here is that, if at all possible, you'll want to make sure that the controller is connected to the device you're streaming from, not the device you're streaming to. When working with smartphones as a secondary device, that typically means using a Bluetooth controller instead of one of the USB-C controllers popular for mobile gaming. Clip-on controllers like the GameSir X2 work great for smartphones, while a full-size Xbox controller won't steer you wrong in general. Just know the main reason I'm emphasizing connecting to the device you're streaming from is that Steam Link has difficulty translating gamepad inputs to something usable by non-Steam apps, even with a Steam input gamepad set up. This means that if you were to connect a controller to your secondary device, the inputs aren't automatically going to be read by whatever emulator you're using. I'm not sure why it's an issue, but it's likely a result of us using Steam Link outside of its intended scope. Of course, this means that handhelds with integrated controllers are going to have a rough time. When I initially connected my Retroid Pocket Flip through Steam Link, I spent a solid 15 minutes flailing about trying to figure out why the controls weren't passing through to Citra. No matter which settings I changed or how much I restarted the connection, Citra just acted as if I weren't pressing any buttons whatsoever when I'd try to change the input bindings. To get my Flip working, I ended up hard coding the controls using Steam input. While the gamepad inputs don't appear to work properly by default in emulators, the actual button presses are being streamed to Steam as intended. Thus, I was able to use Steam input to assign different keyboard keys to each button. From there, it was as easy as remapping controls in the emulator to reflect the new inputs. Afterward, gameplay just felt as natural as always, as if I were streaming the controls properly. For folks who only have a USB-C controller on hand, like a Backbone or Razer Kishi, I'm certain the same method would work just as well. Switching a thumbstick from a joystick input to the equivalent of WASD removes a little bit of nuance from its control, but I haven't noticed too much difference overall, especially while playing 3DS games. It's just worthwhile to keep the expectation in mind that additional setup will be needed if you opt to pass your controller inputs through Steam Link. So far, I've covered display focus issues, optimal display settings, and some nuances to consider for a controller input. You should have more than enough info to go and create your own setup. From this point, I'd recommend you grab whatever devices you have on hand and start enjoying some great dual-screen gaming. Though, if you're looking to build a brand new setup with new devices, here are a few qualities you might want to look out for, outside my general recommendation to just give a Steam Deck a shot. First, primary devices. They're the easiest part of this setup, to be honest. If you don't mind sitting at a desk while you play, a desktop computer with a modern GPU and CPU combo are going to give you the best possible emulation quality. Mine has an RTX 3060 paired with an i7-11700K and works great for both Wii U and 3DS emulation. The two monitors I typically have on my desk already also make using any handheld for a dual screen setup really simple. If you're more of a portable device sort of person, a handheld PC will generally be your best bet, preferably one running some flavor of SteamOS, if you can get it. The quality of controls, portability, and general performance these days are more than enough to form the basis of a solid setup. Otherwise, laptops, or hybrids whose keyboards can get out of the way when not needed, have great form factors for this type of dual-screen gaming. For example, my Surface Book still feels great to prop up and use with a secondary device for this type of gameplay. The point is really to have the cleanest setup and be able to forget that you're streaming from a computer. And Surface devices, in general, tend to be really great for that illusion. As for your secondary device, think about the Wii U gamepad. Ideally, you want something that can get close to its form factor, screen in the center, and controls on either side. As much as I get a kick out of using my Retroid Pocket Flip for dual-screen emulation, having the display above the controls feels a bit awkward and isn't quite as comfortable to either quickly glance at or hit a touch point decisively. Instead, I might recommend something along the lines of a Retroid Pocket 3 Plus or Ein Loki Zero. Both have very solid controls, aren't the most expensive handhelds on the market, and come packed with very nice 16:9 IPS displays. I'd also recommend avoiding most smartphones if you can. Typical smartphone displays tend to have a wider than 16:9 aspect ratio, which leads to larger black bars surrounding the video feed and reduced vertical height of the video feed. If the display is large enough, I'm sure you could get used to it, but it's just not quite ideal. Phones with 4:3 aspect ratios tend to fare a bit better. 4:3 is the size of the 3DS's touchscreen and still feels decent to use for 16:10 or 3:2 video if needed. In fact, a Surface Duo is my favorite device for this kind of use case. It fits snugly into a Bluetooth GameSir X2 and has a fantastic 4:3 touchscreen to use with games, with great stylus support if I need it. In general, just remember that any device you choose will always come with some set of trade-offs you'll need to work around. The cost of being able to emulate games at higher resolutions, on bigger displays, is that no emulation device will ever be absolutely perfect. In general, I just say try to have fun with the tinkering, the experimenting, and the novelty of it all. Even if you can only squeeze out the worst of performance with whatever you have on hand, it's still going to be a really cool setup, you know? Anyway, I'd like to know how y'all are thinking about all of this. Do you have a setup in mind that you're dying to give a shot? Is there a setup you've already tried that you'd like to recommend to others? Let me know down in the comments. Also, as always, if you found this video helpful or informative, go ahead and give it a like, and then get subscribed for more dual screen handheld content in the future. As with all these videos, if you have any issues with your own setup or follow-up questions, you can leave them down in the comments or over on the socials on the screen, and I'll see what I can do to help. A written version of these recommendations will also be made available for free over on Patreon. Links to all that and products mentioned in this video will be down in the video description. That's going to be all for this video, though. Until next time, catch you later.